I received a script, and I mean, just usual audition kind of thing. But I received the script and I read it and absolutely just fell in love. I really loved the aspect of magic and kind of a fantastical world, which I'm always drawn to, but I really loved the balance of real life scenarios and situations and how Brian, our showrunner and writer, really did such a great job of portraying these young women. I would relate it to almost like a Hogwarts in a way. It's where you learn to basically master these powers. These girls and guys can be fairies and girls can be specialists and vice versa. Specialists are trained for fighting and for combat, and fairies are people with, or otherworldly beings, I should say, fairies. They all have their own specific power. So they are all there to learn to basically master them.
You focus, you learn, you grow. Eventually the answers will come.
Bloom is kind of an outsider. She was raised as an only child. She is used to being alone. She's more of an introvert, but she's very stubborn and determined, has her way. And I think that gets in her way a lot in this first season. She basically was born in the first world and was sent over to the other world because she found out that she has these fire powers that are extremely powerful. And she is sent to go and master them at this school. It's a very challenging time for her. She finds out things about her past. She finds out things about herself. And also while dealing with the element of finding out that she has these magical powers, while also just dealing with everyday teenage struggles. I mean, when I read the script, I definitely saw myself in Bloom when I was that age, when I was 16, and dealing with issues, you know, not the same exact issues that Bloom is dealing with, but, you know, the insecurities and the emotional ups and downs and the feeling of wanting to fit in, but not knowing how, and the element of self-discovery, I think, really resonated with me at that age, I should say, because that is, I feel like, for a lot of people, for a lot of young men and women, it's the time where you are trying to figure out who you are.
Magic can be dangerous, as you well know.
Someone's been lying to her.
I think that Bloom, once again, was used to being alone, and that was her, that's where she was most comfortable. And it's not because she liked it. I think it's because it is what was safe for her, because she had never been really vulnerable with anyone. She had never really learned how to trust. And I think her finding these women, these young women, also going through hard times like her and going through their own struggles and also being vulnerable in them is a very important thing for any young woman, any female friendship. I think also finding out that she can trust these girls and actually go through ups and downs with them, show her true self, show the good, the bad, the ugly, and still be loved for it and for her, I think is very pivotal in her journey to finding self-love and self-discovery.
They deserve to know what I am.
Whatever you're thinking of doing, I'm here.
There's this common ground there with Sky. They both are kind of trying to figure out where they fit in, where they belong. And I think that energy is given off to each other. So I think that they kind of start to find a safe place with each other. And we didn't even do a chemistry read, which is really crazy. We were talking about that the other day. It was like, we met when we went to, or when we both got to Ireland, and it was just immediate. When you have chemistry off screen, it definitely translates on screen, it just makes for such a easy work environment.